Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy, Nerd Mode On, and welcome to episode 23 of Battle Reports, a video series where I'll be going over a particular weapon in Battlefield 1 and breaking down the statistics of the weapon to provide you guys with a better idea of how the weapon will perform on the battlefield. For today's episode, we're going to be looking at the Farquhar-Hill. The name of this weapon is derived from its real-life counterpart. Now, just in case you guys are not very familiar with this weapon, let's briefly talk about the historical prevalence of this weapon during World War I. The Farquhar-Hill is a firearm that was designed by Mowbray G. Farquhar and Arthur H. Hill. It was deemed as one of the first semi-automatic rifles of the early 20th century. After several trials and revisions of the rifle, it was found to be suitable for military use, and an official order of 100,000 rifles were ordered for the British soldiers. The British Army appeared to have adopted the rifle in the latter part of 1918, but the war ended and led to the cancellation of the order before any rifles were delivered to soldiers. Now, with a brief excerpt of the history of this firearm, let's transfer over to the variant system and discuss what options are available for the Farquhar-Hill. The available variants for this semi-automatic rifle are the Farquhar-Hill Optical and the Farquhar-Hill Storm. At this point, we've uncovered the two available variants. Let's break down what each variant does regarding the benefits it offers the weapon. Starting things off, the optical variant boosts the weapon's ranged effectiveness. In addition, it grants the player with an enhanced optical sight for increased magnification compared to iron sights. Next, the storm variant provides the player with less visual recoil, which promotes accuracy with sustained fire. At this point, we've successfully explained all the variants for this firearm. Surely by this point you've questioned the requirements to unlock this weapon. In that case, the Farquhar-Hill Storm requires the user to kill 25 enemies with the M1907 SL Trench. Moreover, it requires the player to achieve 10 revives in a single round. Next, the Farquhar-Hill Optical requirements are that the user must obtain 25 headshots with the previous variant of this rifle. In addition, it demands that the beholder accomplish 20 squad orders via their squad leader. These can be simple tasks such as capturing a flag and/or defending a flag or alternative objectives in different game modes. Let's transfer over to the weapon statistics and see what this weapon offers the user when compared to alternative options. It is worth noting that we'll only be discussing the information that is a constant between the variants. As you may have noticed, each variant does provide the user with specialized benefits that are unique to that variant. Starting things off, the Farquhar-Hill has a rounds per minute that clocks in at 257. This rounds per minute places this semi-automatic rifle in the middle tier for rate of fire. Because of this moderate fire rate, the rifle possesses a devastating velocity that clocks in at 740 meters per second. When comparing this velocity with other weapons in the medic class, this means that it possesses the ability to have devastating ramifications for enemies in medium to long range. With that said, the damage model does showcase that the weapon deals a maximum of 42 damage at 46.3 meters. Once we reach 46.3 meters, we start to see a gradual decline of the overall damage being outputted at range. Once we reach 59 meters, the bullets will be doing a minimum of 30 damage. Putting that into layman's terms, all that really means is that the Farquhar-Hill will require a player to land between 2 to 4 bullets to down an individual player. For a weapon of this configuration, it is highly recommended to couple a few headshots into the engagement to increase the damage of each bullet. Moreover, this semi-automatic rifle does have a drum capacity that stacks up to 20 rounds. If you happen to leave at least one round left in the drum, you'll be granted with a short reload that clocks in at 3 seconds. However, in the off chance that you've expelled all of your ammunition, you'll be penalized with a long reload that clocks in at 3.2 seconds. While the penalty for dumping all of your ammunition is not as severe as alternative weapons we've discussed in previous episodes, the difference of 0.2 seconds may be the difference between life and death. Be that as it may, semi-automatic rifles require the player to use any and all of their ammunition effectively to reduce the staggering effect of restricted movement. Ultimately, this rifle possesses qualities that mimics the Selbstlatter M1916. However, the Selbstlatter offers the player the ability to kill with a maximum of 3 bullets to down an individual player. Furthermore, that rifle supports a higher magnification scope to increase stability and enable superior target acquisition. While the Farquhar-Hill can be equipped with a variety of custom engravings to visually highlight the rifle's wooden and metal frame, statistically it fails to disrupt the current meta in Battlefield 1. With that being said, this is all the information I have for you guys. I hope you found something in the video insightful and or entertaining, but until the next episode, this has been NMO, and I'm going to be signing off, guys. Peace!